all you need to know. The Bloomberg Quint podcast that prepares you for the day's business.
Brought to you by IIFL Securities, India's leading broking firm.
Good morning. I'm Alex Matthew, and this is all you need to know at the start of trade. Today is the 2nd of April. You know, there were a lot of April Fool's jokes going around yesterday, not least of which was an article suggesting that Germany's Volkswagen would take over Tata Motors' Jaguar Land Rover business. The company had to issue a statement denying the supposed development, but a quick check of the source would have led to an April Fool's page on Wikipedia. Like I always say, you'll find all the top news on BloombergQuint.com. It doesn't hurt to check. Alright, here's the top news for today. The RBI, after the success of its liquidity infusion method last month, will conduct a $5 billion forex swap auction on the 23rd of this month. And while the swap will bulk up India's foreign exchange reserves, there's concern that using the forex swap may reduce the need for the central bank to buy debt from the market. Incidentally, the yield on the 10-year benchmark bond ended about 3 basis points higher at 7.35% yesterday, ahead of the RBI's monetary policy on Thursday, where consensus is building on expectations of a 25 basis point cut in the policy rate. In good news for the government, goods and services tax collection for the month of February rose to the highest level since the nationwide tax was rolled out in July 2017. The amount was higher by about 9.5% sequentially and 15.6% compared with the same period last year, and it stood at 1.06 lakh crore. The RBI has changed disclosure norms for bad loan divergences that are reported by banks. Now, the central bank has mandated that banks disclose loan divergences in their financial statements if the additional provisioning required on the loan exceeds 10% of profit before provisions and contingencies. Divergences, by the way, are loans that the RBI feels should have been categorized by a bank as non-performing. The Serious Frauds Investigation Office yesterday arrested former vice chairman of ILNFS for alleged fraudulent conduct and causing wrongful losses to the company and its creditors. That's a PTI story, quoting unnamed official sources. In the automotive space, you'll get a wrap later in the day on the sales for the month of February, so do stay tuned for that. As things stand, though, the numbers don't look encouraging. But here's another big update, though. Vinod Dasari, former chief executive at Ashok Leyland, has been appointed CEO of Eicher Motors' Royal Enfield arm. State Bank of India has moved the Supreme Court, challenging the National Company Law Appellate Tribunal's suggestion to give more money to Standard Chartered Bank in SR Steel's insolvency case. In this case, Standard Chartered is an operational creditor and as such falls below other banks in the pecking order under the insolvency process. In other news, Airbnb Incorporated has invested an undisclosed amount in Oyo hotels and homes. While Airbnb and Oyo didn't disclose the amount, a person privy to the details told Bloomberg Quint that it is likely around $150 to $200 million. In international news, the UK Parliament rejected all options in a set of votes on four potential alternative blueprints for Brexit on Monday, all of which would either keep closer ties to the European Union than Prime Minister Theresa May's plan entails, or would potentially stop Brexit altogether. Now, equities strengthened worldwide as strong manufacturing data out of China over the weekend helped allay investor concern about a slowdown in global growth. Yields on treasuries rose the most since January after the reading on a gauge of US factories came in above estimates in March. US stocks rose to their highest for the current year, with all three averages climbing roughly 1.2%. In Asia this morning, the three early rises have begun positive, setting the stage for another strong session in India. And to tell you what to expect from the Indian markets today, here's Darshan Mehta. Morning Darshan, how are we looking at the start of trade?
Hi, Alex. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. The global cues are doing well. If you're looking at the US markets, they were up over 1% in trade. The SDX Nifty is indicating a positive outlook. But we'll start with the auto sales numbers. Weak set of numbers coming in from Tata Motors. The March sales was down 1% at 68,700 units. The estimate was in excess of 71,000 units. Even Hero MotoCorp, when the estimate was 6,50,000 units, the March sales were down 26% at 5,81,000 units. TVS Motors, it was decent set of numbers, coming in line with what was anticipated. 3,20,000 units was the estimate. Their sales was down 0.4% at 3,25,345. In terms of other news, ThyssenKrupp and Tata Steel are ready to sell assets to get the EU merger approval, as per a German newspaper. Both the companies have filed a list of assets they are ready to divest, in which will enable them to get the approval from the European authority. Aisha Motors, Vinod Dasari joins Royal Enfield as the CEO of Royal Enfield. Siddharth Lal will continue to be the managing director of the company. Remember, Vinod Dasari was the earlier CEO of Ashok Leyland. Coal India, the March production was up 10%. Offtake was up 8%. FY19 volumes was just short of the MOU target of 610. The number came in at 607 million tons. Godrej Properties gave their fourth quarter update. They say they've achieved an highest ever booking after the company sold 2,900 homes with a total area of 3.75 million square feet and booking value in excess of 2,100 crores. Scient came out with their fourth quarter update. They say they see and expect a material decline in design-led manufacturing revenues as a large order of $5 million has been delayed. In terms of bulk deals, Pokharna will be in focus. Ashish Kacholia sold in 15 lakh shares in the company. Reliance Mutual Fund acquired 12 lakh shares in this. In terms of brokerages, Macquarie is initiated on Endurance with an outperform and a target price of 1400, which means a potential upside of 22%. They believe they will be the key beneficiary of the safety regulations and the premiumization. Citi has downgraded Persistent System to a sell. They say there are concerns on sustainable profitable growth. The target price has been cut to 605 from 675, and Persistent continues to deliver slower growth versus peer despite the smaller star size and the early start in digital. But there's much more you need to know before trade actually starts. For that, log on to our website bloombergquin.com and click on the All You Need to Know tab, and you will be prepared for morning trade.
Thanks, Darshan, and thank you all for listening in. That's all we have for you in this podcast, but remember, do check the website bloombergquin.com over the course of the day for all the live market action and the top news that you need to know. This is Alex Matthews signing off. Have a lovely day.
I hope you enjoyed listening to All You Need to Know. Did you know that you can listen to this show on the IVM Podcast app? On the IVM Podcast app, along with this, we have a number of other shows which you think you'll enjoy. Listen to Cyrus Says with Cyrus Brocha as the host. Listen to Paisa Vaisa with Anupam Gupta. The Seen and the Unseen with Amit Verma. Or Shunya One, hosted by Shiladitya Mukhopadhyay and myself. Check out the IVM Podcast app to get more talk content that you will enjoy.